Hey, good morning to you all and greet you all in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And this morning, as we come together, let's commit this time into the hands of the Lord. Father God, we thank you, we praise you, Lord Jesus, for yet another day that you have added into our lives. And this morning, oh Father, we are so privileged and blessed, oh Father, Lord, for the care that you give us, for the love that you show upon us, oh Father, and the blessings that you pour out on us, oh Father. And this morning, we commit and submit ourselves into your hand. May this time that we spend be meaningful and encouraging for each one of us, oh Father. And we pray that, Lord, that you would hear our prayers, oh Father, Lord. Thank you so much. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen. As we worship the Lord, let's sing the song that will be displayed.
Till the just don't quite fit in. Every wrong way, runaway rebel, so ashamed of where you've been. This goes out to every searcher trying to fill that empty space. Well, your searching days are over now. Everything's about to change.
Morning to all. Thank you for being here. Johnson, over to you.
Morning, morning, everybody. So, the passage that I've chosen is, I think, quite familiar to most of us. It's about the Samaritan woman at the well, who Jesus offered the living water of life to her, and she mentions that, you know, she would have she's of the line of Jacob, and what is this that he's offering, which is, you know, that is not already known to her? There are two parts which are quite interesting. One is that, having been a Samaritan outcast, yet she identifies herself with one of the most greatest patriarchs of the Christian life, which is Jacob. So that was quite a revelation in itself. But the bigger thing that I looked at is this living water, and that keeps on flowing. And those of us who know Jesus have, you know, got it permanently, right? And That's what is where the difference is. The song that we sang is about come to the living water, and you know, you get Jesus to save you. I was just trying to see that, are these passages only to those of us who are still looking for Jesus and finding and therefore find the living water? What's the significance to us, as those of us who know Christ, many of us who have been born again? What does it mean to us? And for me, I had a very strange revelation and out of this over the last couple of days, is that before I got back into a corporate world, I was doing business and I was doing some landscaping business. And this one of the things that's very interesting in the landscaping business is this automation, right? Where we do automation for lawns. And it's a very beautiful thing to watch. When at an automatic time that you preset in an equipment, the whole system comes alive and the whole area gets watered and it looks fabulous and beautiful. I mean, and we used to set the times at like 7:30 in the morning and 4:30 in the evening. So that's either the rising sun or the setting sun. So you always got a small little rainbow either way. All of that seemed so beautiful. And I was just thinking about it and seeing how that water, that grass looks out for that water. And to that, suddenly what happened was that I looked at our life and then I thought to myself, this living water that Jesus talks about is there in us. But I think the problem really lies at the end of the day is while we all have it and we want it and it's there in us and we need to keep expressing, we sometimes disconnect ourselves from it in the sense that our pump goes off. And that, what I'm saying is that we don't have the, though the electricity is there, we've not switched on the pump. So the pump basically is what I believe is the prayer, the connection that we need to have with God. And that prayer is the one that switches on the pump. And so every time that, you know, we kind of get complacent and we see everything going fine and we kind of think, oh, all is okay, we kind of switch off our motor and we think the water will keep flowing, but actually it starts drying up. And we need to keep revitalizing ourselves and keep going back to the water within us, and that needs to keep flowing, and that only through a pump that we need to switch on. So I looked at the pump as prayer, and I thought, if only we could every day, you know, make sure that we switch on the pump and keep it on, it will constantly be flowing and it will be the one that will guide us through the day. And I mean, yesterday as I was thinking this passage, I had a sudden shock and, you know, the income tax calculations came up and I kind of found, you know, that suddenly more money was being taken than I actually want to give the government. And I really was struggling. Then I prayed to God and I kind of then reconnected and then water flowed over and I kind of see, and like in all of this, He will be glorified. I mean, before it happened, I'd actually thought I'd saved some money. And I was telling a colleague who's a first-time convert in my company, and we have very few Christians in our company, and I was talking about it, and he's telling how God is a just-in-time God. And he was telling his story about he has been through a surgery, and he had a heart stent put, and he's off work for a whole year. But yet God was merciful that every day of that, the year that he was laid off in bed because of this thing, never had to ask for money. Money just kept coming. Somebody would give him and paid every EMI and every debt. So I'm just, you know, that prayer, the connection, I just believe that we need to keep our pump on. That's what I wanted to share. And thank you for all listening. And we just pray that God will keep our pumps on. Thank you.
Amen. Thanks.